Welcome back. I am so happy that you're here. I have all kinds of motivation coming your way, and it's from like different bedrooms, different days, even a little bit outside. I'm finally putting the rocking chairs together that I shared with y'all a while back, and they are so beautiful. They're from Walmart and I love them. I'll make sure to link them down below, but we're starting off here. This was the day before school started for my kids. My boys had some sweet little friends over playing, and we were cleaning up the kinetic sand, and they actually volunteered multiple times to help us, but Kate and I were like, you know what? We can tackle this. Don't worry about it. So we got it all cleaned up, and the rest of the day was spent just kind of trying to make sure that our ducks were in a row for school starting the next day. Like a light lighting up in the dark, you make it right. I forgot how to act, it's so classic. Every time you make me nervous and I lose my words, it's been a while since I forgot them. My philosophy with kinetic sand, I actually love it when my kids play with it because I don't know, it just feels weirdly educational or something, and they really enjoy it. But if it falls out on the table and you don't clean it up, or if it falls to the floor, it's getting swept up or vacuumed up, and over time it will run out, and then we're just kind of done with that particular box or bag of kinetic sand because I don't really want it to last forever. It's how I feel about Play-Doh too, although I would prefer kinetic sand any day over Play-Doh. How do y'all feel? Now I know why never. I've been loving using my balloon arch kit that attaches to the table. I've shown y'all that several times. I've used it for my kids' birthday parties, but from time to time I will use the balloon tape too that you attach to the wall or whatever type of object you want it to be on, and that is also really fun. But I just unboxed a newer balloon arch to me, and it's the one that goes from the floor to the floor, basically looks like a rainbow, and that one has been so much fun to work with. I've already used it a couple times, and I think I'm gonna use it again this weekend for one of my friend's kids' birthday parties. So I will link those below, the kits that I use, the different ones. They're from Amazon. They are very affordable, and then you use them over and over again. So it's a money saver in the long run if you want to do a little DIY for each little get together or birthday party. And I did make a little trip to TJ Maxx and Home Goods twice actually, because this was the first round of stuff, and I tried to use the little hairdryer hack that so many of y'all suggested, and at first it wasn't really working that well, but once I used the hairdryer on the front and the back of the sticker, it did come off a little bit easier. But I ended up thoroughly washing these. I don't show that part of it, but don't worry, I'm not putting these dirty containers in the drawer. And I failed to really measure beforehand, so I thought that these would be the right size for all of my cooking utensils, but they actually were not at all. They were too small. But thankfully, I do have all of the kitchen organization coming up, and there are so many places that I can still use these, and they were super cheap. I think $3 each or $4. But you will see me later in the video come back to this, because I do find some containers that actually work to hold these utensils, but these were not it. I love that I spent a solid 10 minutes in my head saying, like, this will work. No, this will totally work. I'm just gonna shove these in here. This will be fine as long as the drawer closes. And then even when I put some of the spatulas that didn't fit, I was like, this will still work. It's great. It's organization. And sometimes it takes a second for me to talk myself into like the reality of it and how it makes no sense to have these in here. And even when I do them later, well, I'll talk to y'all about that then because I want to pick your brains on something. And the rest of the day, basically, I spent running around. Internally, I was kind of all over the place and felt like a crazy chicken with my head cut off. But on the outside, I wanted to be calm and excited just because, you know, my kids definitely sense the energy that I have, and I didn't want them to have any nerves or weirdness about the first day of school. So now that they are in bed and settled, I wanted to do everything I could to make the next morning, run super smoothly. And so I went ahead and got their lunches together. These containers are from TJ Maxx, HomeGoods. Pretty much every single one you see here, like the ones that hold the vegetables and fruit and their lunch containers. And I just pack in my kids' lunches, mostly the foods that they like, and of course, try to keep it mostly healthy too. But we do a lot of fruits. As far as veggies go, pretty much only carrots and celery and cucumbers. And then they like almost all the fruits. Kate has a peanut allergy in her class, so she can't take any peanut butter at all, which is kind of a bummer because that type of sandwich is one of her favorites. But I packed her a turkey sandwich, and Ava likes turkey and cheese. And the boys like these Hawaiian rolls, but they like their turkey and cheese on the side. They don't like it all mixed in together. So, you know, I just pick my battles. It's what they like, and it's fine. And then not every day, but some days I do give them a sweet treat. Since this was the first day, I definitely wanted them to have something to look forward to. So I pack that. And then I put these containers in the fridge overnight and leave all the other stuff out so it'll be ready. Okay, so yes, this is the next day, but don't be fooled or anything. It's not bright and early in the morning. I didn't get just a super early start on my cleaning because my kids were off to school. I'm not a morning person, so it's really hard for me to get going in the morning. Y'all know, I pretty much get going around 1 or 2 maybe, and then I can last like all afternoon, all evening, into the night. But those hours in the morning are just not my friend. So took me a while to get going. I finally did around noon, I would say. I did get stuff done in the morning, but it just wasn't like filming and whatnot. So I decided to start with laundry because it's always nice to have something working for you in the background, and you know, we're always behind on it. So I got that going. I did want to take a second, weirdly, as we're 10 minutes into this, to introduce myself to those of you maybe who haven't stumbled across my videos yet or have never really even watched a cleaning video. I know these might seem weird at first, but there is a huge community of us out there who enjoy watching them, and some of us enjoy making them. But my name is Joanna Thornton, And I started my channel about, man, 2.5 years ago now, which sounds so crazy. I started it knowing that I love to clean and I love to organize, and I had 4 children, I still do, and it just seemed right. I wanted something to do that filled my cup up and something where I could really tap into that creative outlet. I had no idea what I was doing when I started. I had never edited really anything. I had certainly never filmed myself doing these types of things, but I just started and it took off. And by took off, I mean I've had steady growth. It has not been insanely fast. I've not shot to the moon or anything, but I have the most consistent and loyal subscribers and friends who comment on my videos, and it just means so much. This community here is amazing. And it's not just on my videos. There are some of my very best friends who do YouTube here, and I see some of y'all commenting on their videos too. It's just so fun and neat to see. Makes my heart happy. So if you are new, I would love to have you. I would love it if you would subscribe. Also hit your bell notification because that'll tell you when I post videos. But I'm just a mom over here doing my thing and hopefully motivating y'all along the way.
You rushing across the main street when you first laid eyes on me. I remember, 'cause I noticed you turned your head to really see. Now you've been busy walking that same old way, so you can't see me. Time to step up.
Anyone else wash your air fryer thing just about every single day? This is one of those things where I'm just like, how in the world did I live before this thing? I got it from Costco and it was on sale. I want to say $50-ish. It is so amazing. I mean, we have done everything from chicken fries to chicken wings to cinnamon rolls. I mean, what all have we done in here? It's just insane. Or like if we have food delivered and it just isn't quite crispy enough, I like my fries or my tots to be super crispy. So you can just throw them in the air fryer for a few minutes and they taste super fresh and crispy. It's just been like probably the best money that we have ever spent. Okay, just came upstairs. I don't have a ton of time because I need to make dinner. The kids are home from school, but I did decide I would do a little walkthrough in every bedroom, not deep clean or anything, but just tidy up and vacuum the floors and maybe straighten up some of this craziness. But like I said, the kids are gonna be helping whether on camera here or in the background because many hands make light work.
Can you see me shaking? Hear the sound of my heart breaking. Bless the soul that's aching. Hoping I survive. The feeling lingers on every day of every month. Wishing I just could forget about you. The weight upon my bones makes it harder to move on. Oh, baby.
The girls still love playing with their dolls and all the doll stuff. We get most of it from Target and they share a lot of the bigger things, so they like to trade off occasionally. And so I was just trading that out. Ava used to have the little schoolhouse in her room, and then Kate had the little rolling ice cream van truck thing. So you'll see me trade that out in a second, but it makes them happy to just switch things off and have certain ones in their room for them to play with. And then I just use this time to move stuff around too. I love when I'm moving furniture that I can clean thoroughly underneath it, but I also just love moving furniture around, especially when it's easy and light. And Kate was really happy too, just the smallest things like moving the little schoolhouse in here, moving her keyboard over to this window, and then moving the mirror. And that was enough to make her like the happiest ever.
We were foolish, not that we were cruel enough to do. Stupid, don't you feel that too? The feeling lingers on every day of every month, wishing I just could forget about you. The weight upon my bones makes it harder to move on. Oh baby, don't think that I'll ever forgive myself for losing you.
We are not the best at making our beds in the morning, and I can't decide if it's worth like enforcing, if that's even the word, like encouraging them to do, because Mark and I don't really do it that much either. But it's so easy. It couldn't be easier for them. It's just two zips. But I guess between getting dressed, making sure you have your lunch and your drink and your backpack and that you've gone to the restroom and that you've eaten and times four, it just seems like a lot. But maybe I should add that. I don't know. When they come up here to brush their teeth, it wouldn't be that hard to just zip their Betty's bedding up, because all four of the kids have it now. I don't know if y'all noticed it last time I showed the boys' room, or maybe I even talked about it, but it's just the best bedding ever.
Crashing in the day, blooming in the bright nights. Teenage runaways, watching every sunrise. Sleeping in the car, blame it on the moonlight. Gazing at the stars, turning all the wrongs right. And if you're
I've pretty much decided, and I don't know why I didn't do this earlier, but to keep this Shark Apex Uplight vacuum cleaner upstairs, because this is where the majority of our carpet is and there's a lot of it, and this vacuum is by far the best for the carpet. And keep my other vacuum cleaner downstairs because it works really well on the hardwoods. Little too well, which you'll see later in this video, but this just makes the most sense for now to me, and it's really convenient to have one up here. I used to just bring this up and down, and that's just silly.
I get on your ride, driving on the sidelines. We will never stop looking for the bright light.
Figuring out how to navigate things as far as what to clean in my kids' rooms as they get older is a little bit difficult, and I don't know, you guys can share how you do things in your family, especially if your kids are older than mine. So mine are 10, 8, 6, and 5. And the girls absolutely love it when I clean their room, but I give them a lot of responsibility too. And both of my girls have different types of hoarding tendencies. Kate likes to keep a lot of stuff in her drawers. Her bottom drawer of her dresser can barely even close. It has so much stuff in it. And then her nightstands too. They just have so many random things that just don't need to be in there, especially if it's trash or little rubber bands or something. But Ava tends to like to line all of her stuff up, and you'll see here in a second on her desk. I started to go in and do something with it, and then honestly, I felt so overwhelmed I couldn't even handle it, but it doesn't overwhelm her. She actually likes it like that. So to me, I'm like, I don't really care that it looks super organized because it's not my thing that I'm having to look at every day. So not everything in their rooms is going to be like the most aesthetically pleasing thing, but I don't really care. That doesn't bother me as long as it makes them happy and it works for them. We will go in from time to time and declutter for sure because they can't just have all kinds of stuff. Like when I was cleaning behind her nightstand, I pulled out like a pair of shorts and some clothes and some socks, and I was like, okay, this isn't going to work. But as far as the other stuff, we'll just let it slide.
I'm laying down to compile it. I'll see you in a while, cause this time I will choose you, yeah. I'll choose. You know exactly how they look like this. Holding in a bag full of goods and needs. I need a night like this. Knowing it's a risk cause you're using it. You got all your secrets. I can seem to move this.
What's your favorite bigger chore to do? Mine is by far vacuuming. In fact, I was almost making myself laugh. I think it was last Friday, two Fridays ago, we went to the bowling alley with some friends, and then their kids ended up coming over to our house to spend the night. And it was probably 10:30 at night, and the kids were all hyped up and playing in the playroom. And I just pulled out the vacuum cleaner, and I was just gonna vacuum the landing area, and then I could not stop. So I vacuumed every single room upstairs, and they were probably like, what are you doing right now? But it was just, I don't know, it just is so satisfying to me, and it just makes me feel so good, and I love dumping out everything that's in the vacuum cleaner.
I'm on the sideline where you wanted me. I'm by the byway waiting for your lead. I don't wanna fall in love like this. But I can't help to fall for you repeatedly. I'm on the sideline where you wanted me.
And as far as the boys' room goes, it was not really that bad at all, surprisingly. I just wanted to wipe things down. The top of these lockers get so dusty. And then I think I've mentioned before their little nightstands. I used to have them right next to their bed, but I had to move them out a little bit because Max fell out of bed one night, and the corners on them are super sharp, and it cut the back of his head open. Like, he had blood on his pillow. It was really gross. So I didn't want to risk that happening again, so I moved them out to the side. They don't look the best like that. I'm trying to figure out a different way that I can set it all up, but I'd rather them stay safe than anything else. And while I was doing all this, Mark was finishing up with bedtime with them, so they were alternating. Like, if I was sitting on one bed, they were on the other one, and then they jumped to the other one. And I just made sure to tell them, like, don't hop into the camera, because they had just taken showers and there's just no telling what Bo is wearing or is not wearing. And I didn't want to run the risk of that, but I was just laughing seeing random feet pop into the frame. But this is how we make stuff work sometimes. I'm with the kids a lot during the day when Mark is working and once they get home from school. And then in the evening, sometimes we have to do a little swaparoo so I can get some of the stuff done that I need to get done, whether I'm filming or not. It's just really stuff that is going to give me peace of mind to get it done. And so he'll take more of the responsibility with the kids. It's not like that every single night. Sometimes we double team it, or sometimes it's more on me, or sometimes it's more on him. But over the years, we've kind of just found our balance. And of course, if there's something that we feel like we're not getting from the other person, we just vocalize it. Well, Mark vocalizes it. Sometimes I let it, you know, boil a little bit. And then one day I'm just like, brah! About nothing, but it's just because I haven't been communicating how I should and asking what I need from him. It's not that he's done anything wrong, it's just how I am. And now I'm finally opening up these boxes. I had ordered these rocking chairs from Walmart weeks and weeks ago, and they delivered them, I think, 2 days later. So they've been sitting in my garage, but I just haven't gotten around to putting them together. So Mark had actually pulled out a box earlier and put one together just because he wanted to. So I had three left that I needed to get together and put them out on the front porch. Right now, we currently have a nest up in the corner of our porch, and I lift my camera up there from time to time to see if the eggs have hatched. And I think they all have except one, but that one has been there for a while. So I'm kind of wondering if it's not gonna make it. I don't wanna interfere, but I also really want the nest gone, because with the nest comes, you know, all the fun bird stuff again. And I don't want all that to be all over these new chairs, but it's part of life and it's outside and it's fine. But I can't wait to show you how they look out there.
It doesn't even make sense why I think about you. It was only one night. Only that time, and it's not my style to be caught up in the middle like this. Cause now I dream about you. I was probably too drunk, it's blurry, but I've got the image of you running circles in my mind right now. And it could fade away, but it probably won't, and I should let it be. But I'm gonna dive into you. And maybe I'll drown, but what can I do? And it would be alright to let me down. Rather we try than let these feelings slide. So I'm gonna dive into you.
It doesn't even make sense why we try to fight it. Every time that we touch, the room caught on fire. We could blame it on the wine, but we know that we would both be lying. I wish I didn't want you. I was doing just fine the way that it was. Then you hand me these emotions, didn't want them, but I guess that I'm stuck with them. They could go away, but I know they won't, and I should let it be. But I'm gonna die.
I definitely want to do more out here, especially as it's cooling off a little bit outside and it's more comfortable to sit out here. We want to restain our front posts and the little wood shutters on the front of our house. They're not really shutters, they don't open, but that's always been too dark for us out there. So we would like to redo that at some point and put some more plants out there, but that will all come in time. And I finally put away the kids' soccer shoes because they sat in our bathtub forever. Then I finally cleaned them, and then I laid them out to dry, and then I needed to put them all away. And now I'm tackling this drawer again. And this is the dilemma I'm facing. So I got these little organizers from TJ Maxx, and they fit in the drawer and they fit the utensils, but it almost makes me wonder, like, why are they in here? I needed something to help keep certain spoons with other spoons, but it didn't really seem like it made any difference. So I'm almost tempted to just put them in a little container up on the counter, even though I don't like for my counters to be cluttered. So I was wondering what y'all do and what y'all think I should do. I know that's random, but hearing y'all's perspective is always so helpful. And like I mentioned, I do have an upcoming organization video in my kitchen, all the cabinets, all the drawers, and here are some of the containers that I have to do that. And I'm really, really excited about it because it's just gonna make our kitchen flow so much better. Now I'm going to wipe off the countertops, and I just wanted to show y'all this because occasionally I'll get the comment that I'm wiping a clean countertop, and I can promise you that I'm not. My countertops are always covered in crumbs or some type of kinetic sand, possibly Play-Doh, hair. I mean, you just really never know. And the entire time I am wiping them down, I'm hearing crumbs hit the floor left and right. Because I'm not the type that's just going to work so hard to gather them and put them in my hand. I got to vacuum the floor anyway. So I might as well just wipe the counters like a crazy woman. They get clean and that's all that matters.
Carried all the weight on my shoulder. Had me going never once I told you no. Told you no. Kept going like a marching soldier. Play my part, boy, I had to hold you down. Hold it down. When the tidal waves come around and wipe up what we built, would you fight for love or would you back down and let our hope drown? When the world is everything, it'll break us up for good, would you hang around when all we got right now? Tell me how you feel about us.
Pa' que yo esté contento. La chispa de la llama se apagó lento. Cambiamos mentiras por juramentos. Sabía todo de ella, pero ahora ya no lo sé. Siempre ha estado tan bella.
I didn't feel like I was vacuuming particularly aggressively at this time, but for some reason this vacuum cleaner took up part of my floor. And it was a little bit loose there, so it didn't just absolutely shock me, but it made the weirdest noise and it kind of scared me. And then I had to do a double take. I was like, wait, what? Now the floor is missing? But I've mentioned to y'all so many times, we have engineered hardwoods. We moved in about 5 years ago. That was pretty much at the time kind of like our only choice, or we didn't know any better to pick anything differently. I would never ever pick engineered hardwood. They look beautiful just to the naked eye if you don't really know much about them, but they are so weak. They scratch so easily, they chip so easily, and they can't be sanded and refinished or anything. We are going to replace them and put something over top them. Actually, I think we're going to do luxury vinyl plank, and we're going to be doing that sooner rather than later because it's a hazard to have wood missing on our floors and have kids that run around and could potentially get splinters.
Tell me what your name is. Tell me what you like and all your secrets. I just want to go over the details. Let me inside of your mind. I know I just met you.
Okay, I told y'all in my last video that in the next video I would show how I organize all the kids' schoolwork. And these are bins that I made, and by I made, I mean I put their names on each of these about, man, when was it? 3 years ago, I want to say. And in each of them, they just have all of the grades up to the grade they're in right now. And then I only keep like special papers, ones that I think are funny or have a really sweet note from the teacher. So these are pretty much all of Max's that I'm keeping from last year, which was his kindergarten year. I have not yet filed them. I mean, I'm so far behind. Y'all know how it was with COVID. Like everything's just behind, or at least that's how I am. But like sweet notes like this, his teacher wrote, you know, love you and all that. I'm keeping those just because I think they're precious, but I do not keep a crazy amount. Like this is the entire stack for the year. Bo has a little bit more just because he was in a class that did a lot more work, and his stuff is just really sweet and funny and cute because it was from pre-K. But I'm going to go ahead and get all of this filed away now. And then I realized since I am so behind that I do not have another folder for the girls. So I actually need to go and buy those. But I at least have their stuff stacked up. So for right now, I'm just going to slide these into here. And then when I get a folder, I'll put it in there and label it. But this is how I organize everything. And then when they graduate, if they want to, I'm going to give this to them. And then They can keep it for however long. I think when I graduated, if my mom had handed me a bin of my stuff, like just the special stuff, I would have loved that so much. And I would have held on to it to show my kids too. So I'm gonna do this. If they choose to throw it away one day, that's fine too, but at least I tried. So I'm gonna get this stuff packed away really quickly.
Talking to a stranger with a tattoo. Baby, I'm one of a kind. There's a reason we're here. There's a vibe in the air that neither you or me could deny. Well, I see how you stare up and down everywhere. I can tell you're far from shy. So let's talk till we drop or till we get kicked out. Let's just say what we want.
Alrighty, these are updated for the most part, and I think for now I've been keeping them in their little closet in their bathroom, which is very random, but I think I'm gonna start keeping them in the closet that I'm gonna use right out here in the hallway for their game closet, which in an upcoming video I'm going to be organizing. I have all the stuff for that, so I'm super excited about it. And I'm also really excited about getting the kitchen organized, so that will be coming up too. But I hope you guys enjoyed today's video, and I will see y'all in the next one. Bye guys.
So let's talk.